So, you might be wondering what all this garbage is. Well, I'll tell you what. It's exactly the same as this garbage.
Even though there's an extra line break. But that is actually besides the point.
The point is, this computer is sending data to that computer down there. The monitor
is my 32-inch. And if we get a little closer, you can read. Focus. There we go. So,
how in the heck? Now, the first thing you'd probably think is the fact that there would be an internet connection. But I'm going to tell you that this computer is way too young for that. It is a Toshiba
Satellite Pro 465CDX.
And the means of communication that it has is one 1.1 USB port. I just closed this. It has one USB 1.1 port on the back, right here. An infrared port, a parallel port, a serial port. That one's actually over there. That's the monitor. A PS/2 right there, but I really don't think anybody's going to commute with that. And a modem. And if you stare at the modem long enough, you'll see there's a cord stuck in it. And that cord goes up and around. This is the power, this is the cable for that keyboard, which, as you can see, is not plugged in. It goes up and around, and it's jerry-rigged into that computer. So, the only connection that I have in between these two computers is a phone line. So, now you're thinking that I have used some kind of long-range phone proxy, and what I'm doing is I'm sending the information through that in order to get there, because most of the time modems need a dial tone.
Well, that's not the case, because this is actually a direct connection in between the two computers.
So, how did I do it without a dial tone?
That's easy. This is actually a hyperterminal, which allows me to communicate with computers, and it has the option to dial a number, which is what you think that I've done.
And then, after that, it links two computers together as a serial connection, but you can also do the telnet session through it, which would be pointless on this computer. But instead,
if I bring up the properties, it is direct to the second COM port. So, how did I switch both of the modems out of command and into this data transmission? Which I shall stop. Hopefully. No, I won't. Okay. Alright, I have to forcibly... Oh, wait. I can quite simply hit the disconnect button. There it goes. And over here, it has told me there is an absence of carrier.
So, how did I do it?
Well, if I can get the mouse up here,
I'll show you how. First, I tell this computer to not look for a dial tone, which I can do on this computer as well.
I just have to connect. Okay, so I'm going to get my tripod out here because... Nah, screw it. Alright. Sorry for all the camera jiggery. I don't know.
So the first thing I do is tell it to ignore the fact that there is no dial tone, which is actually M1. Ah, garbage. at M1 does exactly that. And for some reason it thought I told it to start listening. At M1. There it goes. Okay. And I tell that on the other computer, but I kind of already did that. And echo is off. What else do I need to change exactly? You can tell this is a very professional video. Right. Okay, so that was actually the code to tell it that the speaker should be on until the two computers are connected. The command that I actually wanted is ATX1. There we go. And that tells it to ignore the dial tone. And then from there, I switch over to the other computer after I've typed in ATA on this side, but not pressed enter. ATA answers an incoming call manually, since there is no ring indicator established. Let me switch back over to, well, minimize. I tell this computer, which this is going to be hard because the keyboard is way over on my bed. Alright. Sorry for the camera here. ATD. And it really doesn't matter what I type in here, because this is going to dial a number, and it really doesn't matter what that number is. I'm going to make it pulse dial. The number 2. And then tone dial 321, 0. That comma is just a little pause. And that gives me enough time to distinguish exactly when the dialing is done. So, this is where the fun begins, and I shall stay quiet for a little bit. Because this laptop is configured to have the speaker on. Sit down. Oh yeah, I'm sorry for the camera view. Alright. So, that's a nasty glare. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell the first computer, the XP1, the one on the big screen, to dial the number. You should hear it. I didn't switch it out of pulse dial. And then I tell this one to answer the call. And connected. That noise should remind you of dial-up if you've ever heard that before. But instead it was actually this modem handshaking with the other one. Pretty much telling it what connection to do everything at. And from there, I can actually send files, but I'm going to need the mouse, which I put on the floor. The mouse for the other computer. So, in order to send a file, I'm pointing to what file I need. I'm not going to show you that because I'll show you on the other computer. Right. So, what I would do in order to send a file is I would click this button, but instead I'm going to click this one because this is the receiving end. And I click receive after I click send on this one. Boop. There it goes. I think it already received it. Yeah, not bad. Apparently when you open that dialog, it automatically receives. Transfer canceled. Shut up. Okay, so it spit out random junk right before it decided, hey, this is a data transmission. So, and then from there, I can send plain text in between the two computers just by typing. So if I press enter, and then I type on this computer, as you can see, I need to turn the light back on.
T-E-S-T.
And it shows up there. And it shows up. Oh god, this is gonna be shaky. There. Sorry for the shakiness. I really hate that when other people do that, but I've done it. And it's in real time in between the two computers. So you're wondering what happens if I just listen in? Well, it just sounds like static. If I listen in to the two modems talking to each other, which I can actually program them to do. That is done by telling this modem to hang up, which is easy. I go A-T-O. Oh, my bad. I actually needed this. Plus, plus, plus. Okay. This is not working for some reason. Oops. What the heck did I just do there? What is wrong?
Okay.
So I'm just gonna forcibly disconnect it then. Boop. Boop. There we go, and it's no carrier again. So, I established the call again, but this time I'm going to tell it to keep the speaker on after it's connected. Which is that command. I don't need to enter in the ignore the fact that there's no dial tone anymore because it has already done what it needs. So now I'm going to actually properly dial the number. Dial pulse 2, switch to tone 321, 0. Alright. And you should hear that happening. I do not have to type in ATA at this point in time, but I will anyway. And dial. There we go. As you can see, I turned the modem down because it goes through the sound card, and the sound card controller is right there. That little guy. As you can see, if I do this. So yeah, all it does is it sounds like static. And the only reason why you could read the text at the beginning is because I actually limited the speed that it was sent at right here. And now I should show you without any sort of delay. Set that to 0, turn off the light so you can see. And set this one to 0 as well. Very professional video, by the way. And how it was automatically transferring is I told the software itself to send a text file. That option. I have already sent Apollo 13 at full speed to the other computer, to this computer. But I shall do it this way. And as you can see, this is how fast it would be. Which is freaking fast. The connection to the computers is actually much slower than the baud rate that the modem is talking to the computer with. But it still gets the job done pretty quickly. As you can see, that's got a little bit harder to read. Especially since I set both of the delays to 0, but whatever. And what does it sound like when it's transferring data like that? Well, let me turn the audio back on. It still sounds like that. Okay. Really all that I wanted to show you. Yeah.
This is how things used to be done back in the day. This is pretty much for demonstration purposes. If you had a computer like this one, that really the only thing worked would be like the modem. There'd be no other way to transfer files, I guess. That would be the way to do it. The only problem is, if I open up the file that I transferred, which happened to be a picture, you can see, hopefully this has a reader on it. This is Windows 98. There's no Windows 97. Huh. I'm gonna use Internet Explorer. There we go. If you can see, a transfer can take about 6 hours. You know. And that was a file that was pretty large. Ironically, I deleted it. So, yes. This is the modems talking to each other. Okay. End video.